Hello, it's me again.
Hello, it's me again. I got the baby already, the giveaway baby, and I'm painting another baby. This is a Nyla. Nyla, yeah. So I'm gonna paint her along with Johanna. I have Johanna's COA here. So it's Nyla, right? Nyla. I think that's the way you pronounce it. Anyway, here's Nyla COA. She's by Georgia Pickett. And, of course, Johanna is a Reborn by Bountiful Baby. So, Nyla has a belly plate. It's one of those cool wraparound ones. These are like my favorite. I like Laura Lee Eagles does a lot of those. So I'm just gonna seal them. I have another secret baby. He's not gonna be such a secret, or she's not gonna be such a secret. I'm doing her for a special friend. The other secret baby is in timeout over there because I had some issues. It's an older kit, so I had some problems with her. Anyway, we'll get to that later. I have stuff all over my phone. I'm hot all of a sudden. Setting up lights, probably. Lights on me. I don't want it to be too dark today. So, again, we're going to mix up the sealer. My little recipe. Not really anything. It's just the stuff and water. So, but I'm going to show you how to mix that up. How I mix that up. If you want to use that. And then we're going to seal these babies. And then we'll start painting them. So I'll try to include you guys as much as possible. Because I know there's a few people that wanted to see how I paint my darker skin babies. These feet are driving me nuts. So I'm going to put this one here and this one here. They don't want to sit on there. Okay. So we're going to do the sealer. I was thinking, since we have better lighting, maybe I should show you guys the girls. Maybe they'll look better now. Because, this is Serena. Because, the last video I messed with the contrast because it was so dark. So, they looked really pale and, like, without any detail or anything. So this is Annie and Serena, and they have the little barely there eyebrows. Actually, Serena's, you can see them. They look pretty good still. Serena's are actually a little bit darker. So I did a little bit more. I did some texture as a new thing on the nose. I don't know if you guys can see it. Kind of looks like little pores. And she makes her nose look really yellow when I put it. Anyway, you can definitely feel it. Even I can't see it, but Maddie says she can see it a little bit. You guys can see it? I don't know. Probably not on the camera. I like turning the babies like in different angles and stuff because I think. They look cute, you know, like looking at them like this, you can see like some of the details and stuff. So that's a good thing to do too, is like just to turn your baby at different angles. And let's get her good side. Where's your good side, Annie? Is that your good side? There's your good side. Yeah. Anyway, I just love Annie. She's so cute. But she just drinks the blushing. I try to blush her and it just disappears. What do you guys think? You think she looks okay? I don't want to put too much on her and make her look silly. Because, like, Serena, you can see hers. No problem. Made her lips a little too dark. They probably look off because they're shiny, but I might go over those again with the matte varnish. I kind of like the darker lips lately. It's kind of been doing that a lot. Sorry, I'm tilting my head back again, letting you guys look up my nose. Alright, so just thought I'd show you. Maybe they look better. How they look. They look better on camera. I hope so. Otherwise, I'm not putting this part in. You won't see it if they don't. So, again, for my sealer, I use the Liquitex Matte Gel. And just plain distilled water. I just take, I'm going to zoom you guys in a little bit. There we go. I just take a glob of it and put it in the bottom of my glass container. Since I'm going to do a couple babies, I'm going to do these guys and the other little baby down here. I'm going to put quite a lot in. You don't need that much for just one baby. I'm just going to add a little bit of water until it's like a liquid. I don't want it to be like a paste. I want it to be more liquidy, but I don't want it to be so runny that it's just, you know, rolls right off the kit. Okay. You can make it thicker if you want more, like, if you want more grit to your... This is also something you can use to put on the fingernails if you want to, like, use the pencils on the fingernails. I just ordered some more white pencils. And a lot of people have been saying to use black cherry on the, you know, this part of the nail, like right next to the see how you have the little white and then you have the dark line there. So they use it there and some all the way across the nail. Okay, this is getting, you can see it's runny, but it's still kind of thick. So I'm going to put just a tiny bit more in there and that'll be good for me. I don't know where the lid went to my little bottle, but okay, I'm going to zoom you back out now. All right, so these babies are clean. I washed them yesterday, so we're going to go ahead and put some of this on Johanna's head. I just, you know, what is that? Interesting. Okay, so, you know, I just whack it on. Probably a good idea to brush off your kits before you start this, which I didn't do, but it's a good idea. It's dreary outside and it's making me blah. I haven't gotten Maylin done. This is a dense sponge, by the way. It's not one of the kind of spongy ones like this. These ones are really, really soft and spongy. These ones are more dense. Anyway, Maylin. I finished her, but when I cut her bangs, they kind of stuck up a little bit, which is what I was worried about because, you know, human hair. So, I thought I'll just put some black mohair there. And I realized I did not have any black straight mohair. All my mohair is in black is curly. And I do have some that's like meant to be straight, but it's just got too much wave to it. I went ahead and ordered some some more. So, in the meantime, I'm rooting Manuela for, I don't know, the 80th time. And I kept starting on her and then pulling out the hair because I didn't like the way it looked. So, I'm doing alpaca on her now and it looks really nice. So, not pulling it out again. I just am afraid that the bottom part's kind of dark where I've rooted her before. That might show through because the hair's kind of light. But we will see. Okay, so you just go around and, you know, blot it until it looks even. And just turn it to the side. I'm going to do the whole side of her head now and in her ear. Kind of want to pounce that into her ear. So it's supposed to be dreary and rainy like this for a couple days and kind of cold, and then it's supposed to warm back up again and the sun's supposed to come back. So that'll make me happier. I just feel like I just haven't gotten anything done lately. I got a painting done, but I really need to finish a baby. The only one I have to finish is Timothy over there, who's still here. I did kind of lower his price just for a couple days, just to see what would happen. Nobody was interested, so I just put his price back. Eventually, he'll find a home. Some of my babies sit for a long time, I think. I don't know, maybe my style doesn't. I know my babies aren't bad. They just don't appeal to everyone. And also, some people are afraid to buy outside. A lot of people in the U.S. are afraid to buy outside the United States. And I don't think I promote myself very good. I'm not very good at Instagram and stuff like that, you know. I need to get better at that. I need to have my daughter teach me. Maddie's good at that. She's on hiatus from Instagram right now, but she's good at Instagram. She's just not interested in doing it right now, so it's fine with me. She's still drawing, of course, but she's not posting. It's all right. She can do what she wants. I do what I want. It's my favorite saying now. Doesn't always work in all circumstances, but with art, it works. You do what you want. You do what makes you feel right. There we go. Boo, boo, boo. She's looking good now. Yeah, like this, you can hear. It's kind of a light sandy feeling. Going to go make some lentil stew for dinner tonight. Just put it on some rice. That sounded good to me. I love rice. Anything with rice is awesome. Well, not anything, but you know. Any kind of food that I like with rice is, add rice just elevates everything. I'm just going to do her head, and then I'll do the rest of her off camera so you guys aren't bored to tears. Because I'm not very good. I'm not telling jokes or anything. It's this weather. It makes you sleepy. I think I'll feel better and get a baby put together. I feel like I'm contributing So, as the price of my new wheelchair is, it's a new car. Really, you could get like an SUV for that. Well, maybe not an SUV, but you know, a nice car, a nice new car. Definitely not a Tesla or anything. It's about, like, it would be about, well, it's around, like, 28,000 for euro. So it would be, in US dollars, it would be, like, 35 or something thousand. It would be a lot more. But anyway, in the US it is. It's, like, over 30. If you get all the options that I'm getting. Fortunately, I get funding from the government here and from our health insurance, our private health insurance. So, whatever they don't pay, then we just, we pay. I will feel better after I have it, but I may not get it until the fall, because a lot of people go on vacation in the summer, and so things don't get done. And we're going to try to get the paperwork and everything in, like, this week. So we have all the paperwork done. We just have to hand in the sheets would tell how much it is and all the things, all the options and everything, the final price. So, I send all that in, and then we wait to see if we get funding. And it takes, she said, I have to order it. It takes like a couple weeks, or like about a month, 3 to 4 weeks. So, after I order, so. And if I order in August, I'm not getting it until, you know, they won't be able to fill the order until September, because everybody will be on vacation. Okay, so there she is. She's got all her sealer on. So I'm just going to finish up on her arms. And then we'll do Nyla. Or Nyla. It's Nyla. And then I'll do the secret baby down there. And we'll get painting these guys. I might not paint the secret baby for a little while, or I might paint up to a certain point and then finish it later. Finish her later. I love her ears. Look at those ears. I did put the hot water in her head, so you see her head's not as smushed. She has a more natural looking head now. Okay. So. I don't know why I look. You can see I dyed my hair again. I hope everything looks better. I got a new light back here to help. The weather's not helping. It's very dreary. So, I will be back. We start painting. Or I'll go ahead and do the blue layer. Maybe I'll do it on camera. If you guys want me to paint on camera, just let me know. You can put it down in the comments if you want me to do each layer. I won't, like, you know, make you sit through all the parts and everything. I'll just do like on one part, or maybe like what the limbs. And somebody requested that I do the powders, that you can see what I'm doing. So I'll set up more lighting, and I'll zoom in closer so you can see what I'm doing. So the powder one will be maybe a little longer, because I want to show how I do on the limbs and the head. Okay, so that's it. I'll tell you that I paint all my babies the same. I'll paint them just like they were going to be a white baby. If But then I'll start adding the darker layers towards the end. That's worked out for me. Actually, it was kind of an accident because I was painting a baby and he got like too dark. And I was like, well, why not? We'll try this. So I mixed up the, I got the, I think it was Special Moments. They used to say that she would mix burnt umber and blue. And so I went ahead and tried that. And the burnt umber and golden is a little too dark. So the burnt umber light works much better. So that's basically what I do. And I'm, you know, careful about where I put. I don't want to put too much. I would like to do her like the real Johanna. Cause I haven't made a baby that dark before, so I mean in the picture she looks really dark, but probably like in the light she's a little bit lighter, especially in the like around her nose and her in the tops of her, like the T-zone, should be more lighter. So I'll make sure, you know, we're careful not to get in there too much. I'm talking too much. I'll let you guys go, and I'll be back with the next video soon. If you guys like what I'm doing, please like and subscribe, and let me know if you want me to keep painting and do everything on camera. Not everything, but, you know, every layer. So, you know, go get an authentic doll kit and some paint. And paint a baby, because it's fun.